getting ready to put a project on me, and you sitting there like you're going to help, but you done already said in your mind, I ain't going
to. Amen.
That's what I did. I'm going to tell you something y'all don't believe, but it's going to happen.
Amen.
So he said, I stand up here. Keep on postponing like you don't hear. Keep on coming here hearing things being asked to do, and you can help. He said, whatever your hands.
Amen.
Come on now. Some of y'all act like y'all ain't got no hands.
Amen.
But if God take them hands off your body,
amen,
you'd want some hands.
Amen.
And he said, don't touch. Don't touch.
Amen.
You're anointed.
Amen.
You don't touch the anointing like this.
Amen.
Your disobedience. Your disobedient ways. Now some of y'all looking at the floor. I ain't no more floor.
Amen.
Come on. Y'all gonna look crazy when I go to putting out that stuff y'all hanging around. See, you can hang around ungodliness and sin, and I declare you'll start sinning.
Amen.
You can't help it. So I'm there acting all, you know. So when the people came, everybody turned their money in.
All right,
now I'm making good money in New York. That old buddy was sticking out. You know you get proud when you're sticking out.
Right.
I mean, you got $100 more than I got. Come on now. Maybe $50 more than I got. So you feel big. So I came to church that night. I said, let's get Deacon Clay to come and boost off. See, I was a good booster. Because y'all know that.
Amen.
I can go place to raise all kinds of money. People come in and won't raise a nickel.
Amen.
Come on now, there's something wrong with that.
Amen.
But I got up that night and I raised a huge offering.
Amen.
Come on now. But if you were to dig down in that offering, there was nothing I put in.
Amen.
Come on. Do you know when you go to the table to take up an offering, you're supposed to be first partaker?
Yes.
How can I stand here at this table calling on you to give something and I don't?
Amen.
Some of y'all giving your last.
Amen.
But I ain't got my last in my back pocket.
Amen.
But I won't give nothing.
Amen.
Let me show you the outcome. I mess around now, and then God give me nothing, and then when it comes for special, that was the $50. I reached down in the pocket, picked them hundreds back.
Amen.
I had a few. But then that got me 2 20s, and I got me a 10. I looked at the table, looked at the view. A lot of folks in there.
Amen.
Put the 10 back.
Uh-huh.
Put the 20 back.
Uh-huh.
I walked up to the table, brothers, and slapped that $20 on the table like I done something. When I hit the table, my arm stopped.
Yes.
I couldn't even move.
Amen.
Remember, baby? I couldn't even move. God can tie you up in here cutting up, but you can't even move. You'll leave here and go to the doctor that checks your muscles and stuff, and he'll tell you, ain't nothing I can do for that. When God lock it up, ain't no teacher, no doctor can unlock it. So I left the table. When I got to the pew, it's like an angel kicked me in the pew. Bam! He put his foot on it. And I fell on the pew. And it was like God was saying, your sorry self. You're going to teach you a lesson. But he wasn't talking to nobody else. Because see, one thing y'all be thinking, nobody don't see you. But God, I see you. He see you when you're peeling around the money you should be giving him. Come on, because you've been cheating him all the time anyhow. You don't have to give, come on. And then when you get an opportunity to give and have to give, you're going to kick him back and get to that penny. Oh, y'all are mighty quiet.
Tell the truth.
Well, I could hear a voice say to me, you will never, ever forget.
Amen.
What you done. Well, it paid off to any of us. I'm already a hypocrite. When you're backslidden, that don't mean nothing.
Amen.
See, I was backslidden and messed all up in my head. And he ain't talking to me. And I went on out. And to look at the closer I got to my car, the heavier I got.
Amen.
God, where I could not pick my foot up. See, y'all think this won't happen to y'all. Y'all think y'all in a place where this won't happen to you. Then I got in my car, got home, and now it looked like I done got worse. Like I'm struggling to go in my house.
Amen.
And then the Lord said, garnish years, hunger, rent. He named up the things that I needed, but he shut off.
Amen.
He shut them all dead.
Amen.
Don't care how I sung in church. Don't care how I danced in church. Don't care how I acted in church. It did not release the knowledge. But God turned on me. Is anybody hearing me? God can turn a knob on you while you thinking you're all right. And you begin to tell people, I don't understand why I'm going through all this to go to church. See, going to church don't make things what it is.